Yes, they want to replace white people. Stay with me and I'll tell you why. The Great Replacement is a term originally used by a French writer, Renaud Camus, who used it to describe the demographic replacement happening in France due to mass immigration policies combined with low birth rates among the native French. But of course, this applies to many European countries. The UN literally has a program called Replacement Migration. The premise behind it is total garbage. They claim replacement migration is needed in the West to help take care of an aging population. Yes, Africans, Middle Easterners, and Asians who don't take care of their own people are led into Europe because they're going to be good taxpayers, take care of our old people, and save Western civilization. It's the solution to a declining and aging population. Psh, no one really believes this. Stats show the complete opposite. Migrants in Europe and all over the West cost us greatly, and not just financially. About this aging and dying population not having kids, first, populations have always ebbed and flowed. It's nothing to freak out about. There are still millions of young, fit Europeans in their countries who are having kids. And if you ask me, there are too many people on the planet already. It can't just keep going up and up forever. Secondly, if governments in the UN were so concerned about Europe's low birth rates, they'd easily incentivize a baby boom, like in Russia, Hungary, and Italy. There's a lot they can do to make babies happen. But instead, they open the borders for needy foreigners who eat up resources, welfare, and take territory. The truth is, they don't want more white babies. Let's recall my friend Ayla as an example, who issued a white baby challenge in response to low birth rates. She was viciously attacked and shamed by World News. Congressman Steve King was also lambasted for saying, "We can't restore our civilization with somebody else's babies." Let's also recall those who say European women who want white children are racist and that white nuclear families help uphold white supremacy. They don't want more white people. The UN is a wolf in sheep's clothing. They and other hostile elites hide behind "you need workers, taxpayers, people to take care of your old" lies. What they really want is to replace white people in white countries. They don't want them to exist in great number at all. They want them to be extinct. But extinction won't occur because of mass killings, but encouraged through sly propaganda and government policy, through mass immigration against our will, coupled with white guilt programming, and empty words of equality and claims of an inevitable mixed-race future. Before I go on, I want to clarify they. You may say, but they are mostly white. While many of these elites are actually not, and they don't think of themselves as such, most of those who are white are internationalists, and they're not driven by ethnic allegiance or loyalties to their own group. They only care about themselves, their profits, and their desire to gain more and more power and control. They have grown to hate nations, hate peoples, and differences. These are obstacles for their plans for global hegemony. Reasons why they want to replace us. White people are defense number one against globalism and open borders. We got Trump elected, we voted for a wall, and nationalism is rising in response to globalism all across the Western world. White people are number one fighting for free speech, liberty, prosperity, and limited government. Also holding politicians accountable. We invented these concepts. Globalists want a dependent, docile, compliant population that is easy to control. That isn't white people. White men established the greatest military systems on the face of the earth. Weapons, military strategy, tactics, organization, technology, machines, robotics, military equipment, vehicles, even weaponry in space. We fight hard when necessary. Although a few psychotic maniacs have taken control of some European nations, and they clearly have a death wish and love war and violence, the majority of us are good-hearted people who want peace, prosperity, and to be left alone to raise our children and live a productive and stable life with our family. White people set up colonies around the world, building something from nothing. We aren't dependent on the government, but are highly self-sufficient, resourceful, and inventive. We know how to survive without Walmart and welfare, which is funny because we created Walmart and welfare. We also know how to dominate even as a small minority if we need to. We are a wild card that can always be predicted. When faced with incredible odds, we move mountains and overcome massive obstacles, finding ways to survive, and we will continue to do so. White people are independent business owners, inventors, and problem solvers. We build prosperous systems and societies that generally work well. Together, Europeans created Western civilization. White people are rebellious and independent, a blessing, but right now a curse. We don't like being told what to do. We aren't collectivists or easy to control like some others. Although in countries that are homogenous, we do care what others think as we want to live in a harmonious society. White people question, research, challenge, and philosophize. Unfortunately, today there's many that don't like we used to, but historically as a people, we don't comply just because a self-appointed authority says so. It takes a lot to break us down. White people don't always drink the toxic Kool-Aid, the chemicals, GMOs, bad food, vaccines, etc. We shop at health food stores and eat organic, making a soft kill and dependency on big pharma a bit more challenging. White people exist on every side of the spectrum, but generally we are kind-natured and giving, not all in it just for ourselves or bling. We've enjoyed living in mostly wealthy nations for a long time now. We built all that ourselves from nothing and didn't receive aid, didn't have international organizations helping us, giving us money, food, or technology. We didn't get secret tours of existing factories and industries to copy those in our countries. Industrialization came from us, from our minds, from our hands. But we are also inspired by more than just materialism. Physically, we look very different from the rest of the world, shaped by isolation in very cold conditions as well as other variables. We have a bigger concern preserving who we are, including our genetic traits, to preserve our uniqueness. So what is it that maniac elites want exactly? Global control of everything, even human nature. We stand in the way of them living in their ivory tower, weaving a death web for everyone else. I've come to the conclusion long ago that they are simply psychopaths who get off on destruction of everything beautiful and pure, while making money doing it. They hate us because we are the ones who can stop them, if only we'd all understand that they are at war with us. It also seems there's a faction of them trying to manufacture and fulfill religious prophecy they believe to be true, ruling the world from a central place in the middle of it all. They are trying to speak and force things into existence. Elites, including a faction within the UN, NGOs, and governments openly talking about replacing white people, have sinister plans. Create a third world crap hole in the West so Europeans will be overtaken demographically, making it more challenging to fight back against those trying to replace us. These elites have studied us for a long time. They have found a way of turning our compassion and willingness to help others against us. This unique trait has become our weakness. These elites want us gone because they want their competition gone and the potential resistance neutralized. They think long term, and so should you. Support us. Sign up at redicemembers.com. We are facing incredible opposition of those who want to silence us. With your support, we will keep on no matter what. And everyone's been asking, new merch is on the way, so keep an eye on our website. Also, don't miss our live show Flashback Friday on Fridays and Weekend Warrior for members every weekend. See you next time.